Guys who love their women and their cars, but not necessarily in that order. Cruising to the Max contains strong language.
There's going to be a little bit of a race happening here because you've got an XR3i convertible, two XR3i convertibles, XR2, and you've got me.
Coming in, tosser. Oh,
nicely handled there, Mr. Pies.
Do you like that, son? Yeah.
Most weekends, Johnny Pies and his best friend Luke head down to Sutton High Street.
Sometimes if I'm sitting indoors and I'm bored, I'll just go out for a spin. And like hopefully a few people down here will start having a laugh, you know. And we have quite good fun going up and down here all night, giving it some abuse. Cruising is about racing, music, cars, meeting new people, having a laugh, you know, just seeing what you can get away with.
Would you, sir? It suits you, sir. I'd like to race you too, sir. Would you like it, sir?
I can't, sir.
Will you? Oh, please. I want it, sir.
You're refused, sir.
I want it up the bullet. Hard, sir.
Hiya, what's been going on here? There's police everywhere. Oh, look, there's been a fight. Get a lot of fights around here, especially on a Friday night.
It's 11 o'clock in Wellingborough, and Gemma is out looking for the boy racers.
I think it's safe to say that the majority of towns, they do have the boy racer scene, like the cruising scene, because there is nothing else to do. Say I was to go around Wellingborough town centre 10 times, no one out, obvious no one's out, I'll go to another town, and then if there's no one around there, go around another place until you find them. There they are. Loads of them out tonight. People seem to think that boy racers are all dodgy. They all go around nicking cars, and they don't.
Oh, I can't believe all you lot are out, man.
We're always out.
Not last Friday. No one was out. I was a loner. Oh, Jesus Christ. Silly old bugger.
It's just like being in a big family, everyone mucks in together, there's no fights, there's no arguments. I've never known any trouble.
Oh, should we give it some large amount of
fucking tyre rubber?
Yeah.
Oh, hello, huh? Hello, Simon, out the fucking way. Excuse me, mate, is there any old Bill coming down? Is there any old Bill coming down?
They've got a few one-way systems, and they do turn into a race, little racetrack, because they know at the end of the day, if the old Bill's not behind them, they're not going to be in front of them.
I will spot old Bill before anyone else will. I'm always the one that seems to not get caught. But it's only because I've got 6 points, and I don't want no more.
Gary, watch out, Plowman's about tonight. There he is there, look. Plowman is boy racer's favourite copper. He hates him, basically. He's on duty tonight, so we've got to be a bit careful. One of the lot that goes round with us, he's just been pulled by the old Bill. Here he comes. Come on, buddy. I suppose in some ways, yeah, you could understand why they do it, but they're never going to stop people meeting up like this. I can't believe that when he pulled you, man.
He said, is that your van?
He goes, it wasn't you wheel spinning, was it? I went, no, man, it's not wheel spinning.
The
girl race is going out now. When you have a proper race, you get to the point where it's like, whoa, rush, you know, it's a little bit of danger. And if you win, especially, I'm sort of like shaking and it's like, I get such a high on it. I know people do think I'm irresponsible for racing, and it is a fair comment, but anyone that actually knows me or has been in my car when I have been racing knows that I don't just go hell for leather. I use my head.
There's a few times you get the old heart pumping a bit hard, but that's what you want, really. The more of that you get, it's better. You know, that makes it worthwhile what you're doing.
Oh, shoot. Here we go. I get my kicks from watching people running around.
Luke would not let me go to a cruise unless it was clean. Oh, I wouldn't go anyway. I mean, you can't go over dirty motor. Just don't look nice, don't look right. I do it, but it gets yumped because I don't do it the way he would do it. That's the truth of the matter.
You just don't do it
properly. Luke, is that truth, though?
Yeah, you don't do it properly, yeah.
See?
Johnny Pye sells double glazing. He saved up $4,500 to modify his van.
This is one of a kind, though. There's not another one like this in the country, I don't think. So... yeah, you know, that's the image I've got. I've got something what no one else has got.
Gemma is 24. She's known as Crazy Cruiser. Her 15-year-old Astra was a snip at £700.
Have you got a couple of wheels that doesn't matter about the tread on the tyres?
Yeah. What do you want to do with them?
Just to, like, burn out, basically. As you do.
There's a couple. Yeah, they'll be all right, yeah. Both Michelin, so they'll probably take a bit of stick.
That's yeah. All right, and a bit of smoke.
Yeah, I'll definitely smoke a bit.
So how much do you want for them?
£15.
All right. There you go then, mate.
Thank you very much. Right. Do you want to carry them out, or do you want to...?
No, I'll be all right.
Yeah, sure?
I'm hard.
See, you got your overalls on.
All right, cheers.
OK, have fun.
Will.
Thank you.
See ya. I'd be a liar if I said I didn't like the attention I get of people when they sort of like stare at you and like you're driving up the road and like people sort of like look at you and it's like, yeah.
I get a rush out of driving fast actually quite a lot. I like it, and that car, I've got to say, it looks the fucking bollocks. God, that is lovely. Some people get excitement out of drugs or drink, and I mean, I get excitement out of acceleration. Never turn the race down, never. Even if you know you're going to lose, never ever turn the race down. You want to hold up to your camera? No! Oh, he's turned off. Spoiled my fun. Can you believe it? Tosser.
John is called Johnny Pies. He went to work one day with some pies that was left over from the night before, and I'm afraid the lads all took the mickey out of him, and Johnny Pies became his name, and it stuck. But he does like a pie. I expect when it comes to eating it, it'll be with chips, peas, or baked beans, knowing John. To get in the car with John is a bit hairy at times.
I usually hang on and put on the dashboard. Have threatened to pull the handbrake once or twice, but I think that'd cause more problems than enough.
All of us treat our cars like a woman. You know what I mean? It's like more or less... well, it's more important than a woman. that's for sure. You know, it's the thing that we all love.
I always say that if I have an accident in this car, enough to throw me through that windscreen, that's more than likely my car's totaled, so I want to go with it.
I find it quite amusing having a daughter as a girl racer. I suppose thinking back, we've almost raised our children to think that that's the norm, that you race around everywhere. I think it's a family philosophy that we get to move on.
It's just competition at the end of the day, in every single way that is. It's like, my car's better than yours. No, it's not. And my car's faster than yours, my stereo's better than yours, my wheels are nicer than yours. I've spent $4,000 on an A-Reg Astra. People recognise her as, that's her car, she's the crazy cruiser. And she gets lots of people flashing at her and beeping and looking. Even if we go somewhere quite posh, she takes that. Everybody else is in Range Rovers and we turn up in that. It's quite embarrassing.
I just find the whole sort of boy-girl racer scene just a bit odd. I know of one or two that have done without food so that they can buy the wheels and, you know, buy that flashing little light on the side of the car that they've always wanted. I just find it extremely sad. The priorities are all mixed up, I think.
I used to see him lapping around town. I think, you idiot. Then I started getting friends with some of them. And like, I'd drive around in my car and like, you'd have people try and race and you'd be like, all right then, I'll try it.
I think cruising is a substitute for perhaps boyfriends because her friends have moved on to long relationships. And for one reason or another, she's not ready for that.
Boyfriends come and go. This car isn't going anywhere. You only have to ask any ex-boyfriend and they'll tell you. Because they come second best.
Gemma's car doesn't let her down, whereas boyfriends do sometimes, and she can control what happens to her car, whereas men are not controllable.
We're always in control most of the time, 90% of the time. We're in control of what we're doing.
What about the 10% then? 10%
is, you do get the occasional silly boys, okay, who go a little bit too OTT. They're the ones that give people like myself bad name.
I have no objection to John being a boy racer.
As long as he comes home in one piece, I'm quite happy with it. The car can always be fixed, but perhaps John can't.
I'll never worry about crashing or hurting anyone. You can't worry at the end of the day. If you're going to worry, then it's pointless driving. You know, sometimes you have to drive a little bit reckless to win. So if you was to worry about things like that, you would never, ever drive like that. Everyone has a close shave. But you sort of laugh after it after, you know, because you got away with it, and that's the fun of it. Chance I get to put my foot down, I will.
I know there's a bump coming up. Watch out, hold tight!
I think if I can relax, I would enjoy it.
No! God, no! You bastard!
just need three things. That's it. And about 3 minutes. I think I can handle that. Come to Clinique for a fast, free skin analysis and receive your free made-to-measure three-step sampler. Available at all Clinique counters nationwide now.
Shave, never. I only ever use IMAG. I did my legs days ago. Check out how smooth they are.
IMAG cream with new Perfect Touch spatula. Feels smoother for longer. Detergent really make ironing easy. New Bold can. New Bold, bulging with easy iron conditioner, so you'll steam through the ironing.
There is a new way to cool down this summer. McDonald's delicious chicken tikka McSalad shaker.
Make your breakthrough. You can get to work as soon as you get on the train. Check your email. Make a few calls. Write a Word document. Check your favourite website. All in full colour. The new Nokia communicator is so effective, you could get to work before you get to work. Nokia. Connecting people.
On three CDs, this is Renaissance Ibiza. CD one is Laid Back Beach Life. CD two is Funky Bar Life. And CD three is Up for a Club Life. The true sound of Ibiza 2001 with the number one single from Roger Sanchez. This is Renaissance Ibiza.
This way then, guys.
Hey, excellent.
I'm just going to do the front vent.
Fly and Damon work for Max Power magazine, Britain's most popular modified car mag.
If someone gets a certain wheel, it gets photographed in Max Power on a car, and then everybody goes, oh, I like that. They go out and buy it and do it on their car.
And it's about getting your mundane car and just being a little bit more individualistic.
We go around the country, myself and Fly. Fly takes pictures, we write about it. Basically, we just put in a few pages in the magazine a month about what people are up to with their cars.
Hey, excellent.
In every issue, Max Power features a different car cruise.
Started out as more of a car-based thing. It's turned into a lot more people-based now. A lot of the times we'd be getting calls from people saying, come to our town, because that's where it's really happening, that's where a lot of the best cars are, a lot of the best people are.
Let's go to the cruise.
Car cruises rely on word of mouth. Fly and Damon have been tipped off about one in Northampton tonight. Word is, it'll be in a town centre car park.
Left, see? You're
all
right?
I'm going left, I'm going up here.
Why? What is up here then?
I'm going left up there.
What for when it's down there?
I'm going left here.
The cruise scene's just exploded over the last few years.
It's like domino effect now, really, where people are just getting wilder and wilder and we're just there to capture it.
There'll be some guys having spent all day polishing their cars, waxing them, making sure that when Max Power arrive, they are going to be ready. This is going to be their night.
Clive has already been featured in Max Power twice. He spent $12,000 modifying his latest car.
having a nice car is a little bit about posing, and I like to sort of just not whiz around, I like to sort of pose around a little bit so that people can see your car and take it in a little bit.
The wheels, they are about £500 each. Unbelievable amount to spend on wheels and tyres, I think.
Wheels make a car, really do. Different wheels make or break a car.
When I look at those wheels, I think table, chairs. I think of that as £2,000, not four wheels and tyres.
Clive is going to pose with his new wheels at tonight's cruise in Northampton.
Before I met him, I didn't know what a car cruise was, so I suppose you could have classed me as a cruising virgin. If you don't know what goes on at these things, it's amazing. Women get their boobs out, which the men love. Men get their bums out, which the women love.
The girls go to the shows, there's guys there. Guys go to it because there's girls there. So, bit of a bonus, girls and cars. It's like going to heaven, isn't it?
Max Power pull the punters. When they show, so do more cruisers, desperate to get themselves into their favourite magazine. There's a Max Power league table for car cruisers with a bizarre scoring system.
We've got to go and find some girls. Where are the best girls? What's your name?
Georgina.
That's it. All right, hold it there.
The score chart refers to the birds, the burnouts, the arses, the police. Basically, if it's been a good cruise, they'll get a good score.
Good. Well, I made it. Cool.
I think they're just burning them out, just sort of spinning them until they go pop.
It creates huge amounts of smoke, which everybody loves. It makes you sick and it makes you feel really horrible, yeah. But people love it.
Sounds like somebody's just got their tits out. Could be quite amusing.
Stay there.
Not everybody can own an Escort Cosworth. And not everybody's going to get featured in Max Power because they've got a really good car. So how else do they get in Max Power? You've got to be outrageous.
Well, I've always been saying it. One day I'm going to get my tits out for a magazine. It's always like, you wouldn't dare, but it's my birthday, so I thought, why not?
The women also get to see the men's bottoms and their
other parts.
So it's quite a fair, you know, ratio of bum to boob.
There's some whizzy cars here, what I've seen in magazines. There's one just behind me, the blue one with the bonnet up. That's a feature car, very, very whizzy for an Escort.
Some guys will turn up with 30 grand cars. Some guys will turn up with 300 quid cars. There's no boundaries for money.
Out of all the cars right here, mine's the only one here on 18-inch wheels, which is like the bigger wheels so far.
The police have just said, as long as we stay in the car park, we're chilled. Anybody goes outside the car park, you're screwed. Different policemen that react differently in different areas. So in Cardiff, it appears that they like coming out with their batons out so they're going to batter you because you're in the car park. In other areas, it's fine, you just carry on.
10 o'clock, and more than 1,000 cruisers have turned up to play.
I suppose there's a little bit of anti-establishment to it. They enjoy the fact that they're doing something a bit naughty.
If he nails it and does a burnout, he'll get a load of respect for it.
Now, I admire them. I wouldn't have the patience to do half of what they do to this. I just want to get in them and drive them. That's half of it, isn't it? And the good thing is I can drive as fast as I like in this, can't I? This is where I might have to spring into action.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
This is where PC Nice Guy might lose his reputation.
Do you think right.
I like them. You know, I love all the smoke and everything. I love the way they get around and do them.
they're doing it on the road, so unfortunately, I better go and sort them out. See you later.
Bye.
Just want to see who's the best, who's got the fastest car, and who can burn rubber the quickest.
And is it worth getting speeding points for?
Right.
I think in the long run, it's just a bit of fun to everyone, really, isn't it?
We don't go out to kind of get the police. They're not a big major part of the scoring system, but if they turn up, they get scored.
In the score table, they're doing all right at the moment. It's 10:30, so a few hours to go yet. So it's looking good, though. It's looking good. I think they're going to crack the top 10.
We're all compared to Nottingham, because I know Nottingham are top of the table.
Nottingham top of the table.
So we're a town, though. They're a city. Do you know what I mean? We're a little town, got enough cars, enough
cars. No, they're doing well, as you say. It's kind of like, you know, it's a lot smaller here, so they're doing awesome. Really well.
Sorted.
Good fun. A lot of nice cars here. All over the place. Didn't see many breasts though. Bit disappointed.
One over there, mate. Let's go in.
Where?
What, breasts?
No.
In the water.
Are they out? Get out.
Can I have a bit more?
Go back.
What do I want to do that? Because I'm an exhibitionist.
I think that's it. On that note.
Okay.
It's been great. Northampton's been noisy. It's now 12 o'clock. People are going home. I would imagine we'll be going home soon. But I need a drink.
You just can't leave the car.
You can't leave the car, really. I know it sounds strange, but you just can't leave the car anywhere. Because it's not really a good idea to leave it 8 hours in the garage on its own. So I wouldn't want to go on holiday and leave it in the garage.
No way.
No way, you couldn't. You couldn't.
It's been nearly 6 months since Clive has driven his car.
I'm driving it because he's actually banned from speeding. He's going rather fast.
147, a bit too fast, really. There's nothing else on the road apart from me and the police car, obviously. Never mind, I've done it now, haven't I?
I absolutely hate driving him. I don't drive fast enough, or I do it too slow. I don't indicate soon enough, or I do it too late.
She's OK. She's not too bad a driver. It's a little bit worrying because the car's quite an expensive car and it's got some nice wheels and things on it, which are very, very easy to curb at the best of times. So I worry a little bit.
Oh, shit, I saw him there.
It's hurting now. The weather's nice. I want to be out in the car. There's loads of things I want to be doing.
You know, I can't wait another week or two and he gets his licence back and he can do it himself.
He usually goes in T-shirts to the cruise. He's got quite a few of those. 100 T-shirts. And I'd say he's getting on for a good 20, maybe 25 ordinary shirts. He just changes 2 or 3 times a day. But then again, he does sweat an awful lot, so if he didn't change, we'd tell him he was terribly smelly and dirty, and so it's a catch-22 situation.
Yeah? There you go.
So he does phone up and say, have you done any ironing today, Mum? Has so-and-so washed? Is so-and-so ironed? The person that he settles down with is going to have their work cut out with him.
Oh, baby, ejaculates.
John's going out with Luke's sister, Daniela. Luke, I must admit, is very jealous. Very jealous.
No, I wouldn't be jealous, no. I've got no reason to be jealous. We've sort of drifted a little bit, haven't we? Yeah. It's just natural. It's natural, because the difference is I'm around his house just as much as I was, but I'm not coming round to see him no more, do you know what I mean? I am coming round to see him, but I'm coming round to see his sister as well. So it's right, I'm in the right predicament.
Yeah, but I said it'd be awkward for him, but...
If we be truthful, right, any bird we've had or anything like that, we've always discussed it. Now, I can't discuss his sister with him, can I? Let's be honest. I mean, usually it'd be like, yeah, she's right in bed, you can have her, try her next week or something. Swap over. It's just can't get my nuts in. That's the difference, mate.
Can't share them like we used to.
We have shared a few, haven't we, mate?
When it comes to cruising, it's Luke and John. Danielle wants to go and she's not allowed to go. Luke will just not allow her to go with them.
Hello. Are you still coming tonight? Yeah.
It's a South End cruise tonight. Gemma makes a 4-hour round trip to Essex every month.
It'd be about 7:30. Say goodbye.
Sometimes I think I tell Gemma that it's very sad to sit in a car park or just go round and round town. But if that's what she enjoys to do, she's not doing anybody any harm. She's not taking drugs or drinking or getting pregnant.
Cars are a blokey thing, you know, cars and blokes, it's hand in hand. So obviously if you go to cruises, you know, there's going to be plenty of blokes there. I don't know what it is about Essex boys. I mean, they say about Essex girls, but they just seem to be so up for it, I think the word is.
That'll do. Right out on the floor, she can pick that up.
Who can?
Girlfriend. Would be the mother, but she's not here.
Nice of you.
Yeah, I always think of them like that. Give them things to do. Just in case, you never know.
Southend is known as a top cruise. Johnny Pies and Luke head for the seafront circuit to take on the local boy racers.
I get a lot more joy out of driving my car than driving your bird as much. A decent car does increase your pulling power, 100%.
There's a fucking blonde one. Is that a Natura?
Oi, oi!
Get them out!
Oh, no.
See that?
Fucking face like a smacked ass.
I know. Look like a fucking bulldog chewing a wasp.
You fucking wouldn't shag that with yours.
I wouldn't touch it with yours.
And that's saying, saying.
You know what I mean?
Come on, you stupid cow. Essex girls. Oh, it's looking good tonight. This is part of the reason why I love it down here. It's so easy just to forget about anything at home. Just go straight out of your head. It's just, you're just here to, for a laugh.
Around this area, it's very, very heavy with police. You've got to know when you can put your foot down and when you can't. I always try and get one over the police if I can. Southend, we've sussed it now. They do about 5 changes a night. We time it so we come out when they change over, so it's got quite clever now.
Go, Jamie.
There's some really nice cars down here. There's a lot of RS turbos. There's a bloke with a yellow TVR comes down here sometimes. I was hoping to see him again down here because it's rather nice. And so is his car. But I haven't seen him.
Coming around then, mate, it's coming around big time.
I've been wanting to race that
thing
for about 3 weeks.
You're not right about this car, it sounds faster than it is.
Come on, man, you're going to be spotting for me. Spot some talent for me. Oh, I do like this car. It's not as good as the TVR, but it's not far off. No.
What do you reckon? Do you like him? You fancy him? I'll tell him you're coming over, yeah?
No!
It's not that nice looking.
Nah.
You're not that. Hello, Gemma. What's your name?
Mike.
I'm Amanda, and that's Gemma.
All right. How much to pay for that?
10,000.
Is that all?
Let's see. Put your seatbelt on.
I intend to.
No, I'm from the Sutton area.
Sutton?
Yeah, close to Sutton.
How much is your insurance on this thing?
About £1,200.
Is that all?
Yeah, it's not too bad, is it?
Oh, mate. Would like to make it to 25.
Yeah.
Midnight. The police are out in force, some in unmarked cars.
It's not worth it, though, is it?
You've got undercover old Bill, just not worth it. I told you, they're slippery, so you've got to just be slippery off and sort of sit down and call it a night.
It's just give us a patch, because the more they keep telling us to move on, we'll just find somewhere else. If they give us somewhere where everyone knows we can go, have a laugh, but don't let them stop us having our fun.
Sometimes I'll get home and it'll be, like, say 3 o'clock in the morning. It's a case of I can't sleep, so I go on a chat line just to meet a few people. I don't go on there for dirty chat or anything, I just go on for someone to talk to.
Hi, it's Gemma. I'm 24, 5'8", got long brown curly hair, blue eyes. Well, I sometimes look in the mirror and think, God, you're good looking, but each to their own, I suppose. The only thing I can think of that would get me out of this cruising scene altogether is the old settling down part. I don't think I have ever been properly in love because I haven't let myself. And I see friends and they get treated like dirt sometimes, and I will not let anyone walk over me like that. He's 40 and he's getting a bit dirty. Hi, Dave. Well, I'm a bit too young for you, mate.
Chill filtered Metz Schnapps now comes with a more citrusy twist to increase your drinking pleasure. Much better.
This commercial allows you to choose which new PS2 title you'd like to see more of. For GT3, press box A. For Onimusha, press box B. For Red Faction, press box C. Please vote now. GT3 has received the majority of votes.
Now, this is Etruscan. Can you believe this is more than 2,500 years old? I think that is amazing. I mean, look at the symmetry of the form.
Oh, what a great bowl for salad. Some frisée, some rocket, some lovely cherry tomatoes, a drizzle of Hellman's dressing.
People who like food love Hellman's dressings.
Periods needn't mean big pants. New Always Tanga protects better than any other string pad, so grab your free sample. Always talking your body's language.
There is a new way to cool down this summer. McDonald's delicious chicken tikka McSalad shaker.
To load film, 3 different picture sizes, and an index print. Picture taking with the new Kodak Advantix cameras.
It's really that simple.
To be sure, you have to be faithful.
I suppose I just like change.
There's always something out there to catch my eye.
I just get seduced by the novelty.
If you stop using Head & Shoulders and start using cosmetic shampoos that don't work on your scalp, your dandruff will come back. But stay faithful to Head & Shoulders and you'll be 100% flake-free. And your hair stays irresistible.
I'm committed.
It's too good to give up.
So stay faithful.
Head & Shoulders, for dandruff-free, kissable hair.
Since coming here, I've had to find out about everything by asking questions. And people have asked questions to find out about me.
At Alliance & Leicester, we think questions are important too. They help us understand our customers. Once we understand them, we can do what's right for each and every one. Alliance & Leicester, making questions count.
Travelling by rail hasn't been easy recently, for any of us. But now all Britain's rail companies are pulling together to return you to a national rail network you can depend on. Returning you to fast and frequent services. Returning you to comfort. The National Rail Network. It's time to return.
Grace is already getting into cars and motorbikes. She has her own motorbike. And she loves going out in her daddy's car. She just loves cars. She loves racing cars. Clive has said to me, when she's 17 and she's able to drive, she will be a girl racer. She'll have a car and it'll be the best car in the town.
Can I have it then?
Yeah. Need a spoon.
Oh, no, I don't need a spoon. Gosh, that was lovely.
Are you all right, then?
You all right?
Yeah. Right, car, wheels, extra clean, you know, inside, behind, what? Just polish them, and the door shuts, and in the boot, needs a hoover.
Okay.
And, you know, the bits on the...
Sure.
So, do your worst.
Because
it wasn't quite good enough last time. You know what it's like. It has to be just so. I think Clive's done well for himself. He'll tell you he lived on a council estate. You know, you put a penny in his hand and it'll make a pound. Put a penny in my hand and I'll lose it. He could sell, like, ice to Eskimos, which is quite good. Did you do the boot?
Yeah. Go on, I'm sure.
No, I trust you. It's clean enough, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, God, he's got a chip in the front, hasn't he? Oh, shit. Look at Loopy. Shit, I hope I didn't do it. But I did, didn't I? Hiya.
Hello.
What have you been doing?
Not a lot, not really. Got your car balloted.
It looks all right. What's that on the front? What's that on the front spoiler?
I don't know. I noticed it when...
Looks like you hit that or something, have you?
Honestly, I haven't hit it. I didn't do it. Honestly, I didn't do it.
Right.
Honestly, I didn't do it, no.
It's all cracked on there on the front. You know, about 250 quid. So it's a bit depressing. That's what I knew when, I suppose.
Gemma's just got word of a cruise in Nottingham tonight. As they're top of the Max Power League table, it should be a big event.
In Nottingham, there's meant to be 3 to 5 women to every bloke. Sorry, that ought to be interesting.
Cars always attract girls.
nice.
You always look at the car, you think, God, what a nice car. Then you look at the person in it, and if they're gorgeous, you think, oh, you know. Just like I do with Clive.
Along with everyone else, Damon and Fly are trying to track down the Nottingham crews.
That way.
Which way?
Over there, look, there's some guys that must be going.
Police have closed it off over there, so they're going to have to change venues. Cool. But it's just getting the word round to everybody where the venue is.
That's right. I mean, it's one of those that can move wherever, can't it?
Yeah. So, but we've just got to get the word round now for everybody to move, see?
All right. Let's face it, it could always be that a cruise doesn't really happen.
I mean, there is an option.
If the police block everything, we haven't really got a venue to do anything, so...
First gear.
Huh?
First gear.
Right, so where are we going then?
Well, we're going to ask this lawyer. Let's ask the police.
Yeah.
Where are all the cars gone to, mate? Have they been moved on or something?
Oh, chill, well.
How far is that from here? We've come from miles away.
Yeah.
About 7 or 8 miles.
7 or 8 miles.
Oh, no, not more
back
driving,
into the town.
Please!
Along that way and follow everybody else.
Yeah, Chillwall.
Yeah.
Cool, thanks very much, guys.
Yay! Looks like we've got some help from the locals. Don't drive too fast, mate. We've got to keep up.
Yeah, just don't worry.
Well, turn around that way quickly. Follow that lot quickly.
Got to turn round.
Quickly or we'll lose them following all that lot. Because I reckon they know where they're going. Get up behind them now then. Go on, hit it now. They're turning off here,
Another tasty little car. No. It's not tasty. It's got a girl in there anyway.
Too late. Change it and say it.
Midnight, and Gemma's finally arrived at the cruise, just in time to see the car park lights go down.
Oh my God!
They're driving like real nutcases. I think somebody might get hurt. This isn't very nice at all.
You are?
I'm 24 and I'm from Tibshelf in Derbyshire.
And?
I'm 6 months pregnant.
There you go.
With a little boy.
There you go. Off you go.
Oh, my God.
it's just way out of control. This is the stereotypical boy racer. There's been a car set on fire. People are just racing up and down for no reason, and someone is going to get hurt.
This is terrible. It's terrible. This is the worst one we've ever been to. It looks like it's probably a stolen car, just been dumped in here and burnt out or something. That's crazy. How it looks, isn't it?
It is. It's just crazy. A waste of everybody's time, energy, efforts. You know, these guys, they do a fabulous job, but why waste it on a stolen car? You know, there's people actually out there who need real help. I'm not risking my car, my life, or anything, but... grow up for anything like this. I don't feel stupid saying this. Yeah, I do feel frightened. This isn't funny.
It's really upsetting.
It has, yeah. I just want to get out of here.
Look at this.
Oh my God!
I'm more interested in looking at the cars, and there hasn't even been any nice cars. Look at it. So we're going to do one. We're going home.
Go home. It's not very nice. And
we don't
very
like
unpleasant.
It. We're off.
Been pretty good. I've had a kind of like a girl breasts and arse out, 6 months pregnant, which is a new one. So that's pretty good going. But
so what about the burnout?
No, burnouts are going good. Oh, the car thing. That would happen normally if we weren't here anyway.
You can see some guy's gone in with a baseball bat and he's hit all the way along the doors, all the windows, and then all the other shops that are around, he's done all them as well. I don't know why.
We've been to better cruises, but this is pretty wild. Yeah, this is about as wild as it gets.
Everyone's going now. I'm surprised the police haven't been in here yet.
It's winding down now, it's sort of the real hardcore are still here doing their thing. Another few minutes of messing about and, you know, they'll be all away, going into Nottingham, having a drive around, cruise around Nottingham.
These sidelights.
Lots of people racing around here, 40, 50, 60 miles an hour. Cutting people up, shooting red lights, you just can't have it, can you?
Burning cars out and putting windows through, to me it's crazy. I mean, from what we've heard, all the windows have been put through. That's why all the police are out stopping everybody.
Well, it's nothing to do with that. This is an ongoing problem we have. Weekends, not every weekend, but weekends when you get people racing around here.
We have no powers on private land with people driving like that. I'm sorry?
Is that why there were no police there?
I don't know why there were no police there.
I'll be alright. If I can find my way out of here. If I can find my way out of here, I'll be alright.
I thought the cruise last night was awful, absolutely awful.
It was out of control. It was luck that nobody was actually hurt or killed.
If things like this are going to happen in public car parks, you know, they're not going to happen. If it carries on, you know, the whole thing will be ruined.
The police will clamp it down before it even starts, won't they? If that's the thing. You know, the police didn't intervene too much. Maybe because it was so out of control, they probably thought they'd make matters worse. If the scene turns into like Nottingham was, then there's lots of people who won't bother going to them, us included.
The first I heard of it was a phone call about 12 o'clock from her brother to say that Gemma had been in an accident.
As soon as I heard him hit my car, I just shut my eyes. I thought, no way. I'm not too bad. I went to hospital. I got bruising to my spine, but my car's a different matter.
Well, the first thing is, you know, is she all right, really? I mean,
as far as I'm concerned, you can replace cars. Obviously, you can't replace people or bits of people.
I was thinking, oh, I'm going to wake up in a minute. It's a bad dream. I just couldn't believe my eyes when I got out and saw that. And I just kept saying, oh, what about my car? What about my car? Just couldn't stop crying about it.
Gemma's car has been written off by her insurance company. Clive's six-month driving ban is finally over. He and Joanne have blown £600 on hiring a Ferrari for the day.
Can I ever set up and drive it? But I don't think I will. I think it might be a bit complicated for me. So much more than these cost?
I think they're about £110,000, £115,000. Sell the house.
Sell the house, buy 10, live in the car.
Perhaps one day.